Hello, my share bears. Welcome back. Today's video is going to be a ride or die tag for middle-aged beauties. This is a MAB collab. I don't know how many members of the MAB group are going to be doing this, but it was quite a few, and I'm the one that put it forward to be done, because unless you've been living under a rock for the past month and a half, Jaclyn Hill started this tag, and I thought, you know, that's great for you, but what about us people that are a little bit older, who have the crepey skin, or the under eye circles, or the fine lines? So I put it forward that we should do this and add to it, still do the cosmetic portion of it, but add to it the things that we do as older women to combat some of our problems that we have, because we as older women are going to spend more time on our skincare. I know I do, because the problems crop up when you become a little bit older. And sometimes they can be the oddest problems. So I'm going to start this with my cleanser, because that's how you would start your skincare routine. And my cleanser is the Murad Clarifying Cleanser. It is my ride or die. I need this if I'm ever on a deserted island. I need this, especially because deserted islands are warm, and that's when the oils are going to come out. I have oily, acne-prone skin in the T-zone, but my forehead's dry and my cheeks are dry, whereas I have hormonal breakouts around here, which is a sign of aging. You get to a certain age and you may become like a teenager again with your acne. And I think my acne is actually worse now than it was when I was a teenager. So I use this. This is awesome. Mura knows their skincare. I feel like my face is clean when I use it. The next thing I'm going to go into is my serums. And I have three different ones, and they're used during different times of the day. They are used daily. My Ride or Die Acne Clearing Solution, again, Murad, they know what they're doing. This is their 0.5% salicylic acid acne treatment. I use this before I put on my next serum that I'm going to tell you, and the next two actually, because one's used during the morning and one's at night. So I use this. The next one, which I use in the morning before I do my makeup, is the Mary Kay Time Wise Replenishing C Serum. I also have used the Avon one, but I think I like the Avon smell better, but I think I like the consistency of this one better, just because it's a lotion and not a gel. And the gel can feel sticky at times depending on what kind of skin day I'm having. And vitamin C helps to clear dark spots, and it doesn't take them away. Once you've got skin pigmentation, you can't take it away fully, but it lightens it so that it's more manageable. And I did notice my skin was brighter after using it. The next one is my nighttime treatment, and that is the new Clinical Line Eraser with Retinol. Retinol is good for wrinkles and fine lines. I use it at night before I do my moisturizer. The next item I have is eye cream, because all women know, older you get, the more eye cream you use. And mine, this one is actually my ride or die for nighttime. I don't know that I found a ride or die for daytime, but for nighttime, this is definitely my ride or die, and that's the Mary Kay Time-Wise Volufirm Eye Treatment or Renewal Cream. The reason why I don't use this during the day is it is thick and you cannot apply makeup on your eyes after you've used this. I don't have dry eyelids, I don't have oily eyelids, I have normal eyelids, and this makes them a bit too moisturized. So maybe if I had dry eyelids, it'd work. If you had oily eyelids, I wouldn't even recommend this, but this is mine that I use. Next item is I do have a daily moisturizer that I use. I don't know if I'd call it a ride or die yet, but it may be. But for at night, because I am dry in so many areas, can't just be normal and oily. No, I have to be dry and oily. My moisturizer of choice is an oil-free hydrating gel from Mary Kay again. As you can see, I have used quite a bit of it. I'm getting close to the bottom. This is expensive, but I've also had this for 8 months, so it lasts a long time. You use very little, but it doesn't leave your face look feeling oily and slick, and you need moisture. Even if you have oil-prone skin, you need moisture. So it's good to go with a gel moisturizer. Soaks into your skin and just hydrates your skin so that you don't get all these fine lines and wrinkles. Next item I have, which is skincare related, and I would say should be included even in these younger ladies' videos, is your ride or die SPF. Everybody needs SPF. I don't need to tell you that skin cancer is real. Like, that sun damage you're doing to your face, you need to prevent it. And sun damage also causes wrinkles and hyperpigmentation. And really protect yourself. When I was a kid, they didn't have SPF. They had Hawaiian Tropic sun tanning oil so that you got darker, never mind getting lighter or staying skin cancer free. So yeah, nowadays kids should know where your SPF. I have an issue with SPF that I have to have certain SPF because normal SPF just makes my skin crawl, makes me itchy. I'm allergic to something in it. I don't know. Now there's physical and there's biological SPF. This is 100% vegan SPF, and it's the first SPF I found that I can put on my skin and it doesn't make me want to scratch my face off. And that's the Original Sprout. I will repurchase this. I have repurchased this. It is my ride or die SPF. And I put it on my face after I put on my moisturizer and before I start with my makeup. Now into the portion that would be Jaclyn Hill's ride or die. My primer of choice, and I went back and forth on which one I wanted because I have one that is drugstore and one that is high-end. And I said, if I'm going to be honest with myself, I'm going to go with the Smashbox. This is a blemish control primer. It is expensive. It's $52 for me. But if I was told I could only have one primer, I think I'd go with this. Just my thoughts. My drugstore one would be cheaper, but I think this one would be the one I would reach for. Then the next item is the foundation. And again, this I have talked about several times. It is my ride or die. And again, it's high end. I'm sorry. But I know this is going to be matte. It's going to last. It's a perfect color match for me. And that would be the Make Up Forever Velvet Matte in number 30, which I'm wearing it today. I love this foundation. I'm sure eventually I'll find another foundation I love, but this one I've actually repurchased, whereas a lot of them I haven't repurchased, probably because every time I don't know what one to wear, this is what I grab. Plus, it keeps me matte. The next item is concealer, and this I went back and forth on the high end, on the low end, the high end, on low end, and I ended up with the low end. So this is the Avon Everlasting Concealer, and this one is in light. I love this stuff. The worst thing I can say about it is that the product doesn't seem to go up enough on the doe foot applicator, but I have repurchased this a few times and I'm actually almost out, even though it doesn't look like I'm almost out. I do have a backup of this, so I'd have to say this would be my ride or die. Then on to setting powder, and this is starting to look like a freaking Mary Kay, but it's not Mary Kay. My favorite setting powder is the Mary Kay Translucent Loose Powder. The reason why I chose this one is because it does have a sifter in it. It's not too horribly priced. It's not high end like Laura Mercier. It's not cheap like RCMA No Color Powder, which I also like, but this one went out because it's in a container with a sifter. Then on to contouring and bronzing, and I've said before that I don't contour. I have, but not all the time. If I do, I use the Kat Von D shade in light, and I find that this middle color right here is the best match for me. Sometimes I mix it with this. If I'm contouring, usually it's my nose of all things. I think my nose is huge, so I'll contour down the sides of my nose. I have not done it today, so don't say you didn't do a very good job. But yes, I do use that. I also use the yellow one to set under my eyes sometimes, and I have used this to set. So, I think this is probably a lot of people's favorite contouring kits. So, bronzer, again, I'm like back and forth. Do I like this one? Do I like that one? I've been using the Mary Kay bronzer to try and use it up, but if I'm going to reach for a bronzer, it's going to be my Avon Glow Bronzing Powder in light bronze. It smells kind of like, I don't know, it smells sweet and almost like sunscreen. I can't describe it. It is not an unpleasant scent, to say the least. It bronzes up my face. Natural bronzing look, not this, oh wow, you bronzed. This just does a fantastic job, and it would be a ride or die. Blush, I almost reached for it, and if you've been watching, you know how I feel about the Hourglass blush. But if I'm going to be honest, it's going to be the Milani. And this was like, I could have picked three blushes to put in this, and I never used to be a blush person. Never. I was all about eyes, and lately, I don't know, blushes have been my thing. So the reason why I chose this one, it's a romantic rose. I think everybody who tries this loves this splash. It's just a beautiful color. And I did swatch this, and then I swatched my Hourglass blush, and the Hourglass blush in Mood Exposure is a bit more pigmented, but they are almost identical shades. So ride or die, there's more in this pan than there is in the Hourglass. I'd make this my ride or die, and it is less expensive. Okay, hi later. And I have two champagne pops, because I have the face kit, I have the individual from when they first came out, and I did not choose either of the champagne pops. It is a Becca though. It is the Becca, and it's a poured one because I do have texture. The powders can sometimes look really bad, whereas the poured ones are... they're just smoothing. They don't look like this big mess if you have any texture on your skin. And this one is in opal. I think that I am probably going to try and get the poured of the champagne pop too, because I do love that highlighter. But right now, if I'm reaching for a highlighter on a daily basis, it's going to be this. Next on to eyes, and I thought this was going to be my most difficult because I have so many palettes, but if I were to come out and say right now I have to choose one palette, even when I went to the city, it was something that I didn't even think about it, I just grabbed it. First I'm going to start with my primer, and it's everybody's favorite. If it's not this color, it's Ochre, and that is the MAC Painterly Paint Pot. It's great because it'll cover any coloring on your skin, on your eyelid, and your makeup lasts all day. It does increase as long as you set it right away. You have to set it or it will crease. Now I will get into my palette, and I could have gone with the drugstore. I do have a drugstore one that I do love, but I'm being trapped. I want to be trapped with some expensive eyeshadow, I guess. This is the Tartlets in Bloom palette. I have talked this to death. I love this palette. I'm sure everybody has touched this. I know there was the Tartlet, and it was matte, and nobody seemed to like it. But the Tartlets in Bloom, everybody seems to like. And I mean, I have used this a lot, and it barely shows that I've touched it. And I've probably used this 3 to 4 times in a month at least. At least there are times when this is the only palette I reach for, and it's still... looks almost brand new, like good pigmentation. You can get many eye looks out of it. There's decent selection of mattes and shimmers. Next on to eyeliner, and I do not have a liquid eyeliner that I would say is ride or die, I would repurchase, blah blah blah. I don't do wings, so that's not a big deal for me, but for just doing a liner, I always have to go to my Avon eyeliners. This one happens to be always on point. It's not the color I would have picked. I would have picked the brown, which is Sumatra, but this is lavender gray. What I like about these pencils, I don't know where the pencil is. That's why I picked this one up. The reason why I like these pencils is because they are always sharp. There's a sharpener in them. I think the Smashbox also has one. I think I have the Smashbox one that's always sharp. This one is the same, where you twist the lid and it sharpens the pencil to a point. Great deal. These are way cheaper than the Smashbox. I can get these like 4 for $10 at times through Avon. Next is on to eyebrows and L'Oreal Brow Stylist. Ride or die, I have not tried the Anastasia Brow Wiz. I don't know if I ever will because I have heard so many times on YouTube that this is just like the Anastasia Brow Wiz. Why try something that's more expensive when I can get this at my drugstore and it works so well? It's what I use today. And to top it, I'm using e.l.f. Clear Brow Gel, which would be my ride or die brow gel. I mean, how can you go wrong? It's a double-ended one. It's supposed to be for mascara or for lashes or brows. I don't use it for my lashes. I only use it for my brows, so I've got like double product. And it's, what, $3 for one of these? Maybe two? So, my brow product. And on to the lashes. And if you don't know, I don't know where you've been in the past month and a half, 2 months. Number one best mascara ever, ride or die, except that I'd have to bring an eye makeup remover with me. The Essence Lash Princess and the False Lash Effect. Everybody who's tried this has loved this. It's stay put. It doesn't come off with anything except eye makeup remover. I have to use eye makeup remover to get it off. Micellar water doesn't cut it. Great long lashes with volume. Stays all day, like hours and hours and hours and hours. It stays until you take it off and it doesn't clump. Number one, ride or die mascara. If I could only have one makeup product and I was going to be stranded on a desert, this would be the product. This one right here. Next, liquid lipstick. And I kind of went back and forth on whether I would even include a liquid lipstick because I don't wear liquid lipsticks on a daily basis because I am older. My lips do have fine lines in them, but I do reach for them at times and I can always top it with a gloss or a lip balm. So if you prep your lips right, they do look okay on older people, as long as you find a comfortable formula. I went back and forth on whether I wanted to say the Smashbox or if I wanted to say the Ofra, and I went with the Ofra because the Smashbox lasts, but it doesn't last as long as the Ofra one does. And this is in the color Charmed, which I believe was the Manny MUA collection, and it is just a beautiful color. And like I said, these feel good on the lips. They don't flake, they don't come off in patches, and it's a nice color. They last longer than the Smashbox. Otherwise, Smashbox would probably be the winner on that one. Next, I have my lipstick, and here is another one. If you have been watching me long enough, you'll know what I'm going to say. My favorite lipstick is an Avon lipstick, and this is how much it's my favorite. That is what is left. I've actually put this in my drawer so I don't use it all up because I haven't ordered another one yet. This is in Blush Nude, and it is just the perfect nudie pink color. I love this lipstick to death, like to death. That's as high as it's going. That's what I have left. This will probably be the first lipstick since I was a teenager that I actually run out of, and I will probably be sitting there with my lip brush getting all of the lipstick out of even the bottom part of this because it's just that good. If anybody asked me for a perfect pink nude lipstick, this would be the one I would say, hands down. My favorite lip gloss is the Naked Urban Decay Naked Lip Gloss, and it is just, it's naked. That's what it's called. And why I like this is because it's like a pinky nude lip gloss that you can pop onto anything. It doesn't, it's shimmery, but not too shimmery, and it's not sticky. This is a really, really good formula, and I would highly recommend it. And the last item is a setting spray, because once you've done all this, you want something to make it stay. And my makeup setting spray of choice is not necessarily the one I'm going to show you. It's because it's the one I have right now that is made by this company. And it is the Naked, or the Naked, the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. This is good. I like the pump on it. It holds my makeup in place all day, all night, whatever. But it's not particularly this company or this brand. It's not particularly Urban Decay. It is the Skindinavia company, which Mary Kay gets theirs made by them too. And I love the Mary Kay setting spray. I just don't have any right now. So that is why I chose to show this one, because I'm out of the Mary Kay one, which is cheaper than the Urban Decay. But I would go looking for in the Skindinavia brand, plain and simple. That would be my go-to setting spray. So that's everything for this ride or die tag. I want to thank you all for sticking around, if you stuck around to the end of this long ass video. I ask you to go over and find the other members of MAB that have done this. It will be interesting to see what products they are using to combat their skincare issues, and to see what makeup they're using, because something I use isn't necessarily something that would be their ride or die. So that's everything for today. I hope you have a beautiful, beautiful, sunshiny day, and much love. Bye for now.